in the past, or at least with you, that you've shared with me.
I mean, if Michael Jackson would have joined him in the Captain EO show, then that could have got weird.
I agree.
The time that he asked me how he should wax his balls and his asshole really could
That's
have
a later
been
story.
This Brian's eyes.
We're having that story now.
Okay, tell us more.
That was, yeah, I just said, I don't do it how you want to do it. He's like, what's the pain? Blah, blah, blah. Oh.
Well, he knows that our genitals have different nerves than his genitals, right?
I don't know.
That look you just shot me was a, you dumb bitch. How would I possibly know that?
Well.
To be fair, we do, though, so. Jeff should have shared that story with us in a more appropriate setting.
Well, we just did. So, good job, Jeff.
Good job, Jeff. Interesting Disney story.
Disney. That brings up a good deal. Have you been to Disney, Cass?
No, I have never been to a land or world of Disney. Fuck.
What? Like
you're East Coast Disney, Jenny. I'm West Coast.
Yeah,
Disney.
I'm the better Disney.
The East Coast one's the big one, though, right?
Yeah,
like East Coast is Disney World.
Yeah, we're World.
Okay,
bitches.
Not land.
I have a weird story from Disney.
Let's hear it. That's why we're here.
I still have PTSD every time I hear the word Disney.
Ooh, that bad.
Oh, God. Okay, so it's the Monday after Christmas in Orlando, and my awesome friend Rosie hooked me up with a couple of tickets. I met my college friends and her sweet family, and we were all going together, and I thought, you know, it is 29 degrees. Disney's going to be, like, dead. Well,
29 in Florida?
Yeah, it was freezing, and it was
cold for Florida.
Really the coldest I've ever been there. And so I knew, like, people are coming to Florida. They're not used to this. So this park is going to be, like, dead. But, like, I was prepared. We had layers. Like, everything was good. And I just had my daughter with us. She was 4 at the time. So we arrive, and as we're, like, driving, I'm like, oh, I wonder if they have an app for their lines. And like, this was 7 years ago when they were just starting to get apps for these things. And so there's a big red dot and it says, avoid this park at all costs. And so I'm thinking, well, that's gotta be an error because there's no way that it's packed. Bullshit. We are walking through like a herd of elephants, like just going back and forth, like trying to get through. There's so many effing people. And they're not selling alcohol in this park. They sell alcohol at Epcot. But I think now they do actually sell alcohol because they need to.
How would you get away with not selling alcohol around that many children? Like,
God, it was fucking terrible.
I understand those string of words together sounded kind of bad, but you know what I mean? Like,
oh God, it was
apparent.
It was awful. So, Rapunzel or Tangled just came out. And so we go up and we see a line of people. And at this point it's like 11 o'clock. And so we look and we see, oh, show, meet Rapunzel at 11:45. And I'm like, sweet. And they're like, oh, no. Like you want to meet Rapunzel? And we're like, yeah. And they're like, well, the 11:45 is sold out. And so is the 1:30. This is the line for the 3 o'clock showing.
Oh my God, seriously?
I'm like, the park just fucking, what? And they're like, yeah, yeah. So if you want, like, we're waiting for till we have enough and then we're just going to sell it out. And we look at the girls because it just came out. And we're like, girls, can you, like, are you okay with not meeting Rapunzel? The movie just came out. And they're like, yeah, we're fine. We'll go do something else. I'm like, oh, thank God. Mm-hmm. So we go over to the teacups. A 90-minute wait for the fucking teacups.
90 minutes.
Yeah,
Gross.
And it is a line that spirals around and around and around the whole ride. And it took 60 minutes until you get to the actual ramp of where a normal line would start. And so we're waiting, and the people in front of us, like, kind of pivot their hips and start moving people in at that mm-hmm. point. And I just simply nicely say, "Oh, I'm sorry, sir. The actual line actually is, like, wrapped all the way around. It starts back there." And he goes, "Yeah, I know." And I'm like, "Oh, okay. Well, I mean, you're letting people in, like we've been waiting here. Like, you're adding like four people to your line. Like, yeah. Okay, I'm sorry." And you can tell the guy was gay. Like, you could tell. I'm sorry, but you could.
So, we'll apologize to gays later.
I thought all gay people were supposed to be nice and conscientious.
I know. Who gets in a fucking fight at Disney? The happiest place on earth with a gay, I mean...
I have to say, the way that you voiced him over in this story, I was like, was he gay? Why is she making that voice?
Yeah.
He had a flamboyant flair to it.
No, he did. He had hand motions, and then he like kind of did like a
clear sign, you're gay. You use your hands to talk.
So he did this like whatever, and he was like, blah, 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 and like talked under his breath. And my husband, who's super quiet, pipes up and says, "Don't be a douche, dude. Like, just calm down." And so I'm like, what a dick. So I get out of line at the ramp because I've got strollers. So I'm going to sit this one out, waited in line with everybody. So I take the strollers over to the side. Another 30 minutes goes. They ride the ride. But in the meantime, this guy got off the ride and he comes around and he's near me. And he goes, his friends came from another part in the park, and he goes, "Yeah." And this bitch, she was like, "Da na 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 na," and I was like, "Na na 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 na." And then she was like this, and I was like this, and I was da 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 da. And I go, I'm right next to him, like behind his back, and I'm like, "Yeah, that's not how it went down." And he turned around, and he's like, and I was like, "Yeah, you need to, wow. You need help." And like, every time he told the story, it was just like getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Like, we were having like a fist fight, and I was just like, because I heard when he started saying, "And then she got out of line, and that bitch did the same thing that I did." I'm like, I got out of line. I minused numbers. I didn't add to it. I get you were holding a place for your grandparents or something, but, That was how the first 2 hours of Disney went. And to this day, I asked my daughter, "Do you remember going to Disney?" And she's like, "No, I don't." I'm like, "Then we're not effing going with your brother until he's at least 8, because I'm only doing it one other time."
Old enough to remember.
It was 3 hours to meet the princesses and the fairies after that. I mean, it was such a...
I'm one of those people. This is another reason I won't go to Disney. Firstly, I'm not that into Disney, but I don't like standing in lines for anything ever. Yes, Brian.
Yeah, I'm with Jennie. I actually, we took the kids almost the same story. It was horrible. We went to Disney World, and I decided that I will never take my kids back to Disney World until they have kids and they have to experience the same nightmare that we did.
That's smart.
But now Epcot's fun.
I'm sure it's fun, but my problem, like, I will go when there's chances that the lines will be less intense, because I'm that person that pays like double the ticket to skip the line. Like, correct. I will cough up money for that shit. It's worth it. My time is more valuable. I hate lines. I absolutely hate lines. Extensively.
We loved what is the water park? The SeaWorld. SeaWorld was awesome. And then I made my daughter watch Blackfish right after that.
I was going to say, have you seen Blackfish? Like, have you seen how sad that is?
Oh, I need to watch that.
Oh, it's sad, man. It's really good. Like, you, as someone that grew up in a time where SeaWorld was a really big deal, you absolutely should watch it. But be ready, because it's intense and it's sad.
Oh, well, that was fun. You got a little extra. I do now have friends that have said, no, you went at the absolute worst time. Like yeah. half of Asia was there. Like everybody had
a lot of people.
Matching shirts and like the amount of money that people were walking around with like matching stuffed shirts. Animals and balloons. I'm like, ooh, that's $10,000 and that's $10,000. Like, I was like, I have to get out of here. This is too many people. So, but yeah. Anyway, so those, so yeah, thanks. Thanks, Jeff, for reminding me about my my Disney like issues. So
Disney nightmares.
Yeah. So if you have a weird moment, go ahead and send it to itgotweirdpod@gmail.com or hey, follow us on IG and
yeah, go do
yeah,
that.
Yeah, and Twitter because we are going to be posting photos that pertain to episodes and little fun things. And then go ahead and, you know, tell a friend, tell a girlfriend that's sad, like, hey, you should listen to this. This might make your day. And find us on iTunes, rate, review, subscribe, or at least just rate and review. Like if you have a 5-star situation, if you don't think we warrant 5 stars, you can skip that part.
You can let us know, like just hit us up on Gmail or, you know, DM us on IG, like slide in there and give us your pain points there if you really want to communicate that to us. We're happy to hear it.
Yeah.
It's a growing process, this podcast.
Mm-hmm.
It'll evolve.
So until next time, Cass.
Until next time, go find a weird moment.
Go find it.
Where is it? Bye.